Hey guys, it's John here. In this next video, we're going to be covering what's known as the if-then logic. You guys know it probably as if-else statements and else-if statements. These are your main basic logical operators. You can't get away without using them. So the reason why they're called if-then is because it's literally as it sounds. For instance, for instance, it looks like this. So if-then do this. Okay, so it's called an if then. All right, so if condition, then do this. That makes sense. All right, so for instance, if let's go and create a variable for our age. So we have here. Right, so I'm 22. Now, in order for an if then statement to work, which is just an if statement, in order for it to work, it has to be inside a method or function. A method and function are the exact same thing. They're used interchangeably. So this is a method or function called void start, and inside here you can put an if statement. The syntax for one is an if, the condition brackets, and then the open closing curly braces. Inside here goes your condition, and then this is your then logic. So if this is a true condition, then run this code. All right, so for instance, I want to know if my age is greater than 18. So this is where also logical operators come in. So for instance, if my age, I can just say my age here, which is going to get replaced with a 22, is greater than 18. Now, if that's a true condition, then this will be called. So I can go ahead and say debug.log, I am greater, or I am older than 18. So if we go ahead and just go to Unity and we put this on our main camera, all right, you'll see I'm my age there. Now if we go and run it, you'll see here in the console that it says I am older than 18. All right, so this is how it works. So we can do all sorts of things for this. So for instance, this is an example of doing my age. Now what if I wasn't 18? I want to say I'm not 18. Or what if I'm sorry, what if I'm not older than 18? I want to print out I'm not older than 18. The way we do that is with an else statement. So what we're going to do here is I have here an else. I'll go and rewrite it. So if I'm not older than 18, I go ahead and say else, and then I can say debug.log, you're not older than 18. All right. So with this, we have an if condition here. Now, if this is a true condition, if my age, which is 22, is greater than 18, this will get called. If it's a false condition, it's going to drop down to the else, which is down here. All right? So if we go and test that out, and if I go ahead and change my age here to say 17, and I run it, right, you'll see here you're not older than 18. So our first condition was ignored because it wasn't true. So now, what if I wanted to check for something else? This is where what's called an if-else statement comes in. So for instance, say I wanted to also check for if my age is greater than 18 or if my age is less than 5, else invalid. You know, what if I'm just checking for those two things? For as an example, I would say here, else if. All right, and you could say here the same condition. My age is, say, if it's greater than 18, if else if my age is less than 5, and what happens if it's less than 5? Just debug.log, less than 5, and then here you'll have an else, and we say debug.log invalid. All right, so our program's going to start from top to bottom. It's going to go through here. Is the age, say it was 5, is 5 greater than 18? No, so it's going to go down to here. Is 5 less than 5? No. So it's going to drop down to the else saying invalid. Now for my age being 22, is 22 greater than 18? Yes, so this one will get called. Else, if I wasn't, if it was, say, my age was 3, all right, is 3 greater than 18? No. Well, then it's going to check this one. Is 3 less than 5? Yes, so it's going to call this. The else will never get called. All right, so this is the if-else statements. Very, very simple stuff. For a gaming logic one, basically what you could do is you would check, for instance, if some variable was true, for instance, then you would print out a message. So like, for instance, let's have a variable for a can drink. So I would say here, I need to know if I can drink, right? So it's a bool question. So I'm going to say can drink. by default, right now, I'm going to say true. And here, we can go to program. So we're going to go and say here, if can drink equals true, debug.log, you can drink, else, debug.log, you can't. All right, pretty simple, right? So what you guys can go ahead and do is, for an exercise, go ahead and create a program that checks to see if you're alive, and if you're alive, print you're alive, else print you're dead. All right, or do create a health variable and check the value of the health, check and see if it's alive or not, and print out a message. Let me know what you did in the comments, and make sure you're following me on Facebook and Twitter, digitalgaminginstitute.com. All links and stuff like that will be in the description. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.